A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 19th March, on the front page you have Pramod Sawant to succeed Parikar as Goa Chief Minister. So a day after Goa Chief Minister Manohar Parikar died, BJP has announced Pramod Sawant to succeed him as Goa Chief Minister. We had seen how opposition staked claim and wanted to form the government as BJP lost its majority because of one seat getting vacant. But now BJP has roped in allies and is taking claim to form the government with Pramod Sawant as the Chief Minister. Then this is Anil avoids jail as RCOM pays up rupees 460 crore. So we had been seeing regarding this this Ericsson case, Reliance and Ericsson case, in which Ericsson was demanding, the Swedish telecom equipment maker Ericsson, it was demanding Reliance Communication to pay up the money which is due. So the case has gone before the National Company Law Tribunal too. It has gone up to NCLAT too, Appellate Tribunal, and also the Supreme Court is hearing the matter. And we had seen how Supreme Court had given a deadline, and that deadline was on March 19. You know, so that Anil Ambani and three Reliance firms, they have to pay up amount of rupees 460 crore to Ericsson, the company. If they fail to pay up, then the chairman CEOs of these three Reliance group companies would be facing jail, and Anil Ambani was one of them. So now we see that Anil Ambani has avoided jail as he paid up rupees 460 crore which was to be paid. And this is encounters in UP were not fake. So this is UP Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath who backs police action. We have been seeing reports of how there have been a huge number of encounters in Uttar Pradesh since he has come to power. So he says that these were not fake encounters. But he has made statements that those who are in criminal activities, they should be shot down. So that is not the way justice is handled. Then below you have UAE helped diffuse India-Pakistan tensions. So this is UAE Crown Prince who spoke to Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Pakistani Prime Minister Imran Khan. So this has been stated by the UAE envoy that this helped diffuse India-Pakistan tensions. And this is two killed in violence at Odisha's Vedanta refinery. So this is regarding Vedanta refinery in Odisha's Kalahandi district. Here the agitations by locals seeking jobs in the company took a violent turn, and the clashes took place between security forces and protesters, resulting in two deaths. Then on page 3 you have Mizoram Assembly passes bill to detect illegal foreigners. So this is regarding Mizoram Legislative Assembly. A bill has been unanimously passed that seeks to detect foreigners illegally residing in Mizoram. So Mizoram shares a 700 km border with Bangladesh and Myanmar. So this is a bill being passed here. So Assam, we saw the NRC Act going on here. We have been seen quite often regarding the D voters, the doubtful voters too. And now in Mizoram too, steps have been taken to detect illegal foreigners. Then on page 5 you have alert in Malappuram after boy dies of West Nile fever. So we had seen regarding this incident in which a boy has been detected with West Nile fever, and now this boy has died. This could be the first confirmed death in Kerala due to this West Nile virus, which is passed due to mosquito bite. Then on page 6 you have 15 polling booths to be set up for Brew refugees. So this is regarding Brew community. The Brew community actually is from Mizoram, and facing, you know, violence here, they had, you know, persecution here. The Brew community had migrated and is living in relief camps in Tripura. So the government wants them to come back to Mizoram now, but then many Brew refugees have still not come. So now during elections, it is said a total of 15 temporary polling stations are being set up exclusively for Brew community in Mizoram. So these are for voters, Brew community voters who are living in Tripura. So this is a step being taken. It is said nearly 12,000 Brew voters who originally hail from Mizoram, they are living in 6 relief camps in the neighboring state of Tripura. You can see thousands of Brew community people had been lodged in these 6 relief camps since 1997. So it was in 1997 that communal tensions led to them fleeing the region in Mizoram. So there have been schemes which have been brought in, you know, so that they can come back, but not all have. So this is the case. Then below you have NGT pulls up ministry for not furnishing proper data. So this is National Green Tribunal, which has pulled up the Union Environment Ministry for not furnishing proper data on monitoring mechanism for compliance of conditions of environment clearance. So Environment Ministry grants the environment clearance. So how is it giving this environment clearance? So whether it is complying with the conditions for this, that has to be monitored, and that monitoring function is of National Green Tribunal, the quasi judicial body. So it is said that the data which has been provided by Environment Ministry, that is not sufficient. So it says that the data has not been provided. So here you can see what it says is that data furnished is wholly inadequate to evaluate the effectiveness of functioning of mechanism. So there should be adequate mechanism in place. It is the principle, the precautionary principle, which has to be followed in environmental cases. Sustainable development has to be upheld. So to ensure that this is upheld, this is the duty of the tribunal. It is said this is to be enforced by the tribunal, that is National Green Tribunal. So there should be adequate data coming from the ministry, but either the data, it says, has been withheld, or the response of the officer is otherwise inadequate. So this inadequate data is highlighted here, and the National Green Tribunal is asking for full data. So officer concerned has to present before the tribunal the entire relevant data. So here you can see. So it is said that a total of 6,779 projects were monitored. So these were monitored between 2013 and 2018. And the data which has been provided merely mentions the figures of the projects monitored without mentioning the extent of defaults found and the further action taken, in absence of which the effectiveness of monitoring mechanism cannot be assessed. So that is inadequate data highlighted. On page 7, you have repeat MPs' assets rose 142%. So the average financial assets of 153 re-elected Lok Sabha MPs grew by 142% from 5.5 crores in 2009 to 13.32 crores in 2014. So this is an analysis by National Election Watch and Association for Democratic Reforms. The Supreme Court has also highlighted and has asked the government to give detail regarding this significant increase in assets of MPs, members of parliament, after being elected. So this is a data in that context which has been put up here. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is Lokpal at last. So this is regarding the establishment of Lokpal. So the selection of Justice P.C. Ghosh as the first Lokpal has been announced. So this is in that context. Then second editorial is papering over. So this is regarding BJP's alliance in the Northeast. So it is said these are underpinned by political contradictions. So alliances are formed, but they are, you know, in contradiction of how they have to be formed. So differing viewpoints and the political parties come together. Then the lead article is A Prayer for Our Times. So this is regarding unsound judgments and faulty moral reasoning. So it says that this is not the lot of leaders alone, but also those who support them. So not just leaders are having such faulty moral reasoning, but also the supporters. Then this is A Fatal Margin of Error. So this is regarding the inconsistent and arbitrary application of death penalties. So the article argues that this remains a matter of great concern. There have been demands being made that death penalty should be eliminated, that is capital punishment, that should be scrapped, but that has not been done yet. So it says there's a fatal margin of error here. Then on the op-ed page, you have an interview with UP Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath. Then on page 10, you have Mali reaffirms its India First policy. So there have been three pacts signed during External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj's visit. So Delhi will consider a request for a stadium, which Maldives has also made. So this is regarding, you know, it is said that three agreements have been signed, which officials call first full-fledged substantive bilateral engagement at the political level with the new government in Maldives. Then on international page too, there's nothing important. It's the same New Zealand massacre case in which the detail of the suspect, and even New Zealand considering having tough gun laws as such is discussed. Then on the business page you have day ahead of deadline, Arcom pays Ericsson. So this is regarding the Reliance Communication Ericsson case, which we discussed on the front page too. And this is ArcelorMittal gets NCLAT nod to buy SR Steel. So resolution plan has also been accepted. So final order on promoter's appeal would come now. Then this is 131 CA's refute economist's claim on GDP base year revision. So it says rebasing exercise was set in motion by UPA. So that is what the CA's say. Then on page 14 you have anti-profiteering body can act sans complaint, means without complaint. So it can do mock purchases to see invoice too. So consumer complaints, it is said, are not the only trigger for national anti-profiteering authority to act. So this is what its chairman B.N. Sharma says. So this is there. So anti-profiteering authority is, has been established as anti-profiteering in GST too. The provision as such. So under the Central GST Act, the NAA body has been set up, GST Act of 2017. So this is regarding that. Then on the last page you have India on the brink of a dry eyes disease epidemic, say study. So age, urban residents, occupation and socio-economic affluence are among the risk factors for dry eyes disease epidemic in India too. And early diagnosis and treatment is crucial. And the, lastly, this is Japan to make a crater on asteroid. So Japan Space Agency has announced that its Hayabusa 2 spacecraft will drop an explosive on an asteroid to make a crater there and then collect underground samples for possible clues of origin of the solar system. So this is the asteroid named Ryugu. So this is where the crater would be formed. That is it. Thank you.